particularly like the vampire?
Well, I trained and was also an instructor on the Jet Provost, and the vampire, even though it's a lot older, flies very much like the Jet Provost, handles the same, and it's a typically British aircraft sort of training.
Is it a nice aircraft to fly?
It's a rewarding aircraft to fly. I suppose it's a bit like a typical 1950s British car. You know, it's got lots of idiosyncrasies, but it's very rewarding and good fun.
Now, am I right in thinking that it's got no ejection seats or anything like that either?
No, it does have ejection seats. They're not like the ejection seat today where you can sort of use them at 0 feet. They're limited to 200 feet minimum and 120 knots, so there is a grey area where you can't actually use them.
And what was the de Havilland Vampire used for in its early days?
Well, initially it was conceived and built in 1943, used by the RAF as a fighter, single-seat fighter. The aircraft I'm flying is a two-seat Trenny derivative, and in fact it was the first jet fighter to fly from the Royal Navy's aircraft carriers and land there as well.
Didn't it also do some trials of no-wheels landings as well, if I remember?
That's right, yeah. They experimented with a rubber deck on the carriers, and Commander Eric Brown was the first guy to use that system of landing with the wheels.
What engines were de Havilland using at the time?
Well, it was the first jet aircraft they'd built, so it was their first engine.
So there weren't any jet engines at the time?
Well, there was the Whittle engine, but they never used that. In fact, the Gloucester Meteor actually used a de Havilland engine to start off with before using the Whittle engines later on.
Following the Sea Vampire into service with the Navy was another twin-boom de Havilland jet, the Sea Vixen.
The Sea Vixen had a very protracted